Hi, so I'm DoorDashing, right? And I haven't had to call DoorDash support in a while, but today was the first day I finally had to call DoorDash support. I'm expecting to get half pay of like $3.50 because this was like a $7 or $8 order, I think, because they don't have the order there. Their system's down, so I had to cancel it, get half pay. This support agent just gave me like $11 of half pay, meaning this would have been a $22 order for about 4 miles if I finished it. God damn it, that's annoying. So after a while of being on, my car's AC kind of likes to stop being on. I mean, it's on, you can hear the fans going, but it's not doing anything. It's not actually pushing out any cold air. So I have to do this just to feel even the slightest bit of a breeze. But given I am currently vlogging, we're not gonna do that. I've seen a lot of people just sitting out in their garages, which I think is like, I mean, it's cool. It's a very thing that you see people doing in the movies, like boomers just sitting around in their garage eating, drinking beer. There's a cat. I don't know if you can see the cat, but there's a cat. I don't know, I've seen a lot of it. Anyway, it is 11:58. I was kind of hoping that I could get my DoorDash done tonight, or my dash finished before midnight so that I could cash out and then I don't have to worry about like it rolling over to the next day. Because then I won't be able to cash out until the day after that, which would suck. But it's not gonna happen. I'm still 12 minutes away from my last delivery, which is this Checkers order right here. Which, by the way, Checkers, very slow, but I took this one because it was 12 bucks, and it was going very close to home. Like you guys know, I dash a zone like northeast of where I live, and this was going southwest from where I was working, basically to where I live. So, that's why I took it, because I knew it was going to be my last one. And then I got a McDonald's stack on top of that for $5. Found a little trick with DoorDash that you're with McDonald's that you're probably not supposed to do, but I did it anyway because I've had two McDonald's orders tonight that were, well, this one was just $5 going about 0.6 miles. But before that, I had a double stack order from McDonald's that was going about 4 miles for $10. But I got there and the drive-thru was absolutely packed because it's one of the only places open this late. Well, I say that. There's a lot of places open this late in Florida because Florida doesn't care about coronavirus. So they've stopped with the closing early and everything's 24 hours. Again, it's a really weird feeling, but that's just how Florida is. Anyway, I just pulled around. I wasn't about to wait in the drive-thru because it was one of those double drive-thrus too. They had two lanes and they were both completely packed. I would have been there forever. So I just drove around, went up to the window and said, "Hey, I'm here for DoorDash," and they had both of them ready already. I would have just been sitting there not doing anything, not getting the food to the customer, and the food would have been going cold if I hadn't have just driven around and done that. So I did that for both of those things, both of the times I went to McDonald's, and they didn't question it. The second time I did it, the woman looked a bit weird at me. It was a different McDonald's, but she was kind of like just staring at me blank. I was like, "Hey, I'm here for DoorDash." I gave her the last three of the code, and she's just staring at me. I'm like, "Hi," just staring at me. She's like, "I need the full code." Keep in mind, McDonald's never asks for the full code. They only ever ask for the last three digits of the six-digit code. So that was why I only gave her the last three. But I was like, "Oh, sorry," and I gave her the full code. And she got me that order out to me. I think I've made pretty good money tonight. I do. I need to do my calculations at the end. But I think I did pretty decent. I mean, it's a Friday night. I kind of expected it. There's been no peak pay. That's not true. There was $1 peak pay for about an hour and a half. But I just got very lucky with orders. I've seen very few lowball offers. I've seen a lot of double digits. And I'm pretty happy with that because it's not been like that all week. So here's hoping that trend continues. It probably won't. Probably is because it's a Friday night and there's just more people ordering. But who knows? I'll give you my totals when I get home. I think I did decent. I've only been out, according to my timer, which has disappeared for some reason, 5 hours and 58 minutes. It'll be damn near 6 hours by the time I'm done. I did take a short break and go home for a little bit because I delivered near home and I needed to upload some videos and like do metadata and stuff like that. And I figured I'm nearby home. I'm gonna do it here instead of on my phone. And I also got some food while I was home as well. So I've been out since about 5, but I've only been active for just under 6 hours. And I've made decent money, so see when I get home. It's hot in here now.
Well, I got home. I laid myself down on this bed, kind of like this. This is how you lay on a bed. And I fell asleep. It is now tomorrow. On my totals, that's what I was supposed to be doing. And I just shut my PC down too. Oh great, I have to bring it up on my phone. Alright, so totals for today were $112.99 from DoorDash and $39.64 from Uber Eats for a total of $152.63. And that's an hourly, because we did 6 hours, $25.44 an hour. Very successful, I gotta say. But could be a fluke, could be a unicorn day. I have no idea, but we'll find out, won't we, by doing future days. Good, bless you, Dad. So that's gonna be it for today. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.